Hello everyone, welcome back to the Music Ball. My name is Joe and I'm back with another reaction video. We're going to react to a video called Favorite Michelle Williams Live Moments from Destiny's Child Performances. Okay, so backstory on this, shall we? So Destiny's Child is a popular R&B group that started in the year, I believe it's 1995, 1996, one of those years. But it was in the 90s, right? They first came in the spotlight. It was a song called No, No, No. It was part two featuring Wyclef Jean. And then they released, there were four members, Beyonce, Kelly Rowland, and then there were two original members called LaToya and LaTavia, if I'm not mistaken. So, these four girls, they had this R&B group, and during the second album that they released called The Writings on the Wall is when they basically, you know, they became mainstream. Like, they blew up. They had a huge song called Bills, 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 and then followed by Say My Name. Say My Name, Say My Name, which I love that song. And this is where, like, they were selling now millions of copies. I mean, they were already selling millions of copies with the first album, but The Writings on the Wall is what made them, I guess you could say, a staple R&B group coming into the year 2000. Now, behind the scenes, though, there was a lot of drama between the girls and management, et cetera, et cetera. And LaToya and LaTavia were let go, bringing in two new girls, Farrah Franklin and Michelle Williams. So these two girls, along with Kelly and Beyonce, they continued the rest of the era. The Writings on the Wall would Say My Name and another song called Jumpin' Jumpin'. But the Writings on the Wall era finished. And so Farrah Franklin, I don't remember if she was let go or if she asked to leave. My guess is on the first one, but let me know in the comments, Destiny's Child fans, what you guys remember. But so now we get to Beyonce, Kelly, and Michelle. It's now a trio, okay? And we get to the Survivor era in 2001. And it starts off with a song called Independent Women, Part 1, for the Charlie's Angels soundtrack. And this song pretty much blew up. I mean, I think it was 13 weeks at number one, and followed by Survivor, the hit song, and then Bootylicious. And so the momentum was there. And I think, as you know, for me as a fan of music and someone who has followed Destiny's Child over the years, I honestly feel like the trio of Kelly, Beyonce, and Michelle, that's when it just felt more genuine, more real. It wasn't a manufactured girl group anymore. It felt more like a sisterhood. And we've seen that over the years, obviously, with the next album and then the several reunions they've had, et cetera, et cetera. There's a sisterhood. There's a vibe, a friendship that they truly care about each other beyond the music, right? So with that being said, Michelle Williams, who was a third member of the group, is many times overlooked. One of the most famous ones that I can remember is an incident when she fell on 106 in Park during a performance, and people were very, you know, kind of looking at her like, But all that to say, I actually really like Michelle Williams. She sounds so great in Destiny's Child is because the three girls have very different voices, and blended in, you know, together, it's just, it makes for very diverse, but sonically it sounds great. I don't know if that makes sense what I'm trying to say. All in all, I think Michelle is great, and one of the great things with the new era of the three girls is that we actually got to enjoy each girl, you know, in several parts of songs. You know, they would each have like little solos, and we could appreciate their voices as well. So, and that's what we got with Michelle. That's why I think some of the songs, some of the Destiny's Child song, Michelle has the best parts. And I'm sure we'll get to that in this video. But I'm rambling way too much now. Let's get to this video, shall we? This is Favorite Michelle Williams Moments on Destiny's Child. Here we go. Hey. This is one of the first performances as a trio I remember. Okay. Look at the crowd giving her some love. Okay. Hey. Okay. Okay.
Walk with me.
Ooh.
Walk with me, Lord. Walk with me.
Yeah, I like that second version better. Okay.
Now that I need you, wherever you,
yes,
go,
I love this cover.
Now that I need you, wherever you, you go, that leads to your ocean. You'll never see me fall apart.
Santa Claus coming to town. Santa Claus is coming to town. Santa Claus is coming, y'all. Have a holly jolly Christmas. It's the best time of the year. Oh my golly jolly, have a holly Christmas this year.
Santa Claus coming to town.
The 8 days of Christmas. I love that song.
Have a holly jolly Christmas. It's the best time of the year.
Okay.
Oh my golly jolly, have
those
a holly
harmonies.
Christmas.
Yes.
I didn't really know not to let
all. Oh, this is a Janet tribute. I forgot they sang Let's Wait a While. I love that song.
Let's wait a while.
Always love me. Remember I said the same thing to you, don't. After all,
okay,
of the darkness and sadness, soon comes happy day.
Come on. Okay.
After all of the darkness and sadness, soon comes happiness.
You better sing.
If I surround myself with positive things, I'm gonna gain my faith.
I remember the choreography.
After all of the darkness and sadness, soon comes happiness.
Come on. Wait a second. Let's go back. She was gonna take me to church. Why was that clip so short? Let's go back to that, please. Take me to church. Hey, this is yes, yes, Stevie. Such a soulful tone. She's feeling herself there. Okay.
Zone
the night. I'm a soldier. I wasn't into the song at first, and then it grew on me. Yes. Okay.
He don't know it might be holding night. Only looking good, talking
Okay.
Oh, I love Girl.
Through hell, we never see you down like this.
Oh, what? Sing it, Michelle. Come on now.
Ain't nobody worrying.
Ooh.
Ain't nobody crying.
Okay. But she's so cute. Those harmonies. Oh my God.
That in my life I will see.
You better sing.
And into hopelessness or giving up. Of suffering, that's the least I can do.
Yes.
Cater to you.
Pause. Before we get to this song, not only is Cater to You my favorite Destiny's Child song, but hands down, Michelle has the best part in that song. Obviously, the lyrics and the melody, it's so beautiful and stunning and all that, but the way that she sings it, it's like you just, it takes you, it's its own moment, okay? Like, I will play Cater to You just to hear Michelle's part. Like,
through the good, the bad, the ups and the downs, I'll still be here for you. Cater to you, cause you're beautiful. I love the way you are.
Like, oh my God. Okay. She sings it more beautiful, obviously. So let's hear this, please.
That's the least I can do. Cater to you. Through the good, the bad, the ups and the downs. I'll still be here for you. Let me cater to you. Cause you're beautiful. I wanna cater to my man. My strength, my will to you.
Ah, acoustic.
Let me cater to you.
Come on, harmonies. And I'm so glad they finished on that one. Oh, man. See, y'all better give... I feel like now, retrospective, like current years, people have now been giving Michelle some flowers and some love because, like, yeah, I remember there were a few years where people were, like, hating on Michelle, and I never understood why. I don't know. Maybe it's a fandom. I guess you could say that. But yeah, I mean, this is a great collection. Michelle's voice is very unique in terms of, like, she has that soulful gospel, like, you know, that big voice. She takes us to church, and we saw it in that one clip. Let me know in the comments what you think. But I think her entering the group was such a great addition. And I'm going into a rambling, so I'm just going to stop. What do you guys think about this video? Let me know what you guys think in the comments. But for now, I'm going to say thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and hit like, and I'll see you back here for the next video. Bye.